Right, shorthand dictation, 120 words per minute, 7 minutes or 10 seconds, 5 seconds. Now write down. Mr. Deputy Speaker, sir, we have been talking proudly of the economic progress of our country. In this connection, I would like to point out that the biggest industry in our state is the agricultural industry. But in this regard, I feel that we have not played fair with the agriculturist, because today he is in great plight. In my opinion, one of the reasons for the present state of affairs is that it is the small agriculturist who from the large majority of the land powers in our state. They are suffering on account of the fact that their occupation faces many dangers over which they have no control. One of them is the vagary of the monsoon, and the other is the lack of irrigation sources. The third is the failure of investments in raising crops which could not be harvested because they have failed on account of pests. The agriculturist is also not able to do collective cultivation. I may mention that one of the first things that the new government should take upon themselves is the stabilization of prices. I would very much like that the agriculturist must be assured of a good price for his produce. There is no such assurance now. Today the prices are at a certain level, and at the time when the agriculturist tries to sell his produce, the prices fall very much according to the likes of the speculators. I think this is a risk which he has to suffer. So I am sure it is necessary to stabilize prices. In this connection, I wish to point out that even in rich countries, agriculture is subsidized. It is a fact which we see throughout the world. I have given examples of rich countries where the farmers are intelligent and where there has been mechanization of agriculture. If agriculture is not paying, even in those countries, it must be much more. So in a poor country like ours, where small agriculturists farm the majority, so agricultural subsidy must be a part of the policy of any government. As far as I can see, no provision has been made for his in our budget. The future government should be take into consideration this factor and take steps to stabilize the prices of agricultural produce. Then only they will be able to make the agriculturist stand on his own feet. Then if we introduce a policy of insurance for his crops, we can improve his lot. Then so far as the middle classes are concerned, their plight has been discussed in this house again and again, and I need not go into that now. There is one other matter to which I wish to refer, namely the question of textbooks for primary school children. I have been suggesting again and again that the textbooks for children of primary schools must be of the best type. So far as this matter is concerned, I made a suggestion in the past for this purpose that the best men in the educational field must be recruited for the purpose of selecting textbooks for small children, for we know the future prosperity of the country depends on the quality of education which we are able to give to our children. This is a matter which should not be delayed. Further, It is a sorry state of affairs that the textbooks which are prescribed for children are not available for many months. So it is the responsibility of the state to supply proper textbooks for the primary school children at the right time. Letter from Surya and Company, Kolkata to Messrs. Murali and Company, Mumbai. Dear Sirs, we thank you for your order. As desired by you, we have booked your order dated the 3rd June for 200 pieces of cycles together with the accessories. In this connection, we regret to inform you that there has been irregular over supply in the Kolkata industrial region during the past 1 month, and our program of production has been affected. It has resulted in a huge backlog of orders, so it will not be possible for us to execute your order according to the schedule of delivery agreed upon. We are trying to fulfill our commitments to the best of our ability. Even then, supply may be delayed by 3 to 4 weeks. We are very much regret the inconvenience caused to you, especially in view of our long and satisfactory business relations with you. But in the present circumstances, it will not be possible to allow any claim for compensation since the delay is due to factors entirely beyond our control. In spite of the fact that we have suffered some losses on account of the present difficulty, we are ready and willing to maintain the prices agreed upon if you are able to confirm that the ordered quantity will be accepted when supplied. We await your confirmation at an early date and we assure you of our best attention at all times. Yours faithfully.